Alrighty, welcome to Give It Up or Turn It Loose. James Brown, Bootsy Collins. We're doing the version off the In the Jungle Groove album, which came out in the 80s, 1986. It's a remix of the live version off the Sex Machine double live album when Bootsy was there with the band. There's two other versions before that, both with Charles Sherrell playing the bass, and those two versions are super funky. One of them's off Ain't It Funky album. The other one I found off Startime, I think. Maybe it came out as a single. They're both super funky, but they're not the the Bootsy bass line that kind of uses the whole, all four strings and that sort of thing. So we're not going to play through the whole song either. It's over 6 minutes, but we're going to get through the first bridge, and that'll give us everything we need. We are going to visit the drum breakdown, because that's the best place to hear the bass line. There's nothing else going on but drums and bass there for a little bit. It's later on in the song, maybe 5 minutes in. Let's see, and then we'll do some breakdowns, you know, break everything down, try to do it half speed, that sort of thing. So let's get to it. Give it up or turn it loose. The second bar, of course, that's part of what makes everything funky here. So I'm gonna try to play this in half time. So that pretty much is going into the second bar. So I'm gonna do that again. I'm gonna repeat that a few times just to break the two parts up. that's pretty straightforward. Into the second bar, the second measure, that's where things start to get weird. I used to play this. The first time I learned this tune, I used to play this. Straightforward walk up where every note's kind of getting the same amount of time. Second way I started playing it was this, where I hang on the major third there on the D string, that G flat right here. So I heard him doing this. So I thought I had that down. Then I realized earlier today, actually, that he's hitting this fifth note, this A note on the D string, a couple times. He's doing a quick little doo-doo. So this is the way I think he's really doing it. So I'm going to play all three of those, one after the other, and cycle through them a couple times to hear the subtle differences. The first one being the most straightforward, and then we start to get funkier. So I'm going to put it all together, but the thing that really makes it funky, I think, is that that second bar where he's hanging on this note, that major third, and then he's hitting this fifth note, you know, twice instead of something like that. So let's put it all together. I'll try to stay slow this time. Pretty standard James Brownish. Let's see if I can do it in halftime here. So it's pretty standard, that little walk up there, where one of them's quicker and the other one is slower. I like to throw in those fills. One of the fills I'm doing is, and the other one I'm doing is, let's see. So let's go through that, that walk up he does right before he gets back to the main part when they're getting out of the bridge. So he does a little tease there the first time the horns get really high. He does a little tease. And of course, James, you know, he starts saying, hey, 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 hey. You know, he's saying, we ain't ready to go back yet. So let's see if I can do that little tease. I'm not going to do it in real time, but I'm going to try to do both. Because the little tease that happens, he kind of goes back in a kind of a weird way. Let's see if we can do it. So that's the kind of tease part. So when he does it for real, you know, he goes way up high to the 12th fret. So let's see if we can do that. Let's try that one more time. Because he hits each of those notes twice. So it's... I'm actually not doing it twice. I'm doing like a little lead up there. Let's see if we can do it. So back to the top there. All right, now I want to check out this thing that helps me sometimes. When the drum breakdown happens, and then the bass comes in, you know, those are the only two things that are playing. And so this is a time when I really like to actually turn my amp off and play the tune as loud as you can, probably, without waking the neighbors, and play along to it. And you start to sense if... You kind of feel if what you're playing, because you can't really hear what you're playing, but you can feel what you're playing, and you kind of can feel if what you're playing matches what's being played. And that's, I think, a way easier to do it, way to do it, rather than have your amp up loud and you're playing, and you get so excited about what you're playing, you kind of lose sight of what might be the original part. And so we're going to see what that looks like here. You're not going to hear what I'm playing, but we're going to hopefully hear through the speakers here. What's going on, and we'll see what it looks like. And you can kind of see if your fingers are in the right place at the right time, you know? Let's check it out. Give It Up or Turn It Loose. If you like that one, check out Super Bad and check out Sex Machine. And those are the three we got going this time. Alrighty. Thanks. Keep it funky.